Welcome back to the Elbow Channel. In this episode, we're going to go to the center of Japan, Gunma Prefecture, for some outdoor adventures. It's one of the hottest areas during the summer, so to cool off, we're going to set up camp, cheat death and jump off a huge waterfall into the river, explore nature, let go of our earthly desires, and enjoy some cold noodles. Hey, I'm Elbow. I came to Japan as an English teacher, then moved near Tokyo to pursue my passions. I became a filmmaker because I love cars, Japanese culture, and a good story. I'm lucky enough to live the JDM dream, and so my videos are about my car life in Japan, where I go to car meets and visit shops, do track days and toge runs, build and review cars, and shoot vlogs, short films, and documentaries about Japan's car culture and history. Join me and my friends on our adventures and find out what it's really like in the land of the rising sun. So hop in, fasten your seatbelts, and enjoy the ride.
この番組はご覧のスポンサーの提供でお送りしました。
Hey guys, so it is super hot today. I'm in Gunma and it is probably like 35 degrees. We're gonna try to escape the heat and we're gonna go to the river and do some river adventures. So we're gonna be taking the Forester STI. I'm here with my fiance's dad, fiance's little brother, and Anthony. And so let's just go and escape the heat. All right, so we have the Forester STI all set up for today's adventures.Looks great, and we have a whole bunch of stuff. Let's just show you the back. And you can see we're all ready for a full day of adventures. Anthony's gonna leave his drift car over here back at his place.
Hello!
Hello! Hello again!
Sweaty.
Yeah, oh, what is this?
Bunch of water gun.
Okay!
Trust the Americans to always be strapped.
Nice, nice. Yeah, you gotta stay strapped. Yep, yep.
Whoa there, fuck that. I forgot to stay strapped. She said, where your pee-pee go? I guess that I misplaced that. This shit don't make any sense at all. Cause I just don't feel the same without a dick between my balls.
Just keep that Glock in your back pocket.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, by the way, nice. Nice Hunter stickers over here.
Oh, yeah, it's
so nice. Alright. All right. Okay, let's get some snacks.
Get some snackos.
So I left my little barbecue pit back home, so we're just gonna get some food and snacks from the konbini, and we'll enjoy river snacks. And me too, lemon tissue. It's like my favorite summer food. Yes, chuka. It's like cold noodles.
So, what all do you have today, Abo?
Well, we have a bunch of lemon tea because we have a bunch of coupons. Some Pocari Aquarius, not a cup of Pocari Sweat, and a bunch of sandwiches. The really cool thing about Japan is that you can get really, really good, pretty delicious, pretty healthy food for not very much, and it's consistent everywhere. Compared to 7-Elevens back home, I always feel like 7-Elevens here in Japan has so much more variety and quality and consistency, and it's just a staple of living in Japan. You just stop by the konbini on the way to another spot that you're going to. Personally love 7-Eleven the most, but other people love Lawson's or Family Mart. What's it? Dachisuke? 7-Eleven. 7-Eleven.
So Elbow, you're a Subaru owner, right?
Indeed I am.
You own a vape?
Oh yeah, it's over here.
Right there.
Skin vape.
Yeah, the only acceptable vape.
I wasn't sure if you were gonna get it. That's bug spray.
Oh really?
Yep. That's the only vape that you can see if you buy my car.
Old stomping grounds.
Yep. It's where I used to live. Fujioka City. Fujioka means wisteria hill.
Wisteria hill.
Yes. Wisteria flowers. How do you put the tent up, Albo?
Alright, so we're gonna set up the tent. Chill here. This is the best spot because we have shade.
It is. Let's also see how long this tent takes to set up. I'll set a timer.
So check the timer.
Yeah, all of your Instagram followers always ask, Albo, how long does it take you to set up the tent?
Well, a couple minutes. The hardest part is actually just rolling it up. You'll see what I mean.
Yeah.
1 second. Now see, when we roll this up, see there are these straps here.
Ah, straps, like right here. I see.
These straps have to go on these like little hooks.
Whoa!
We're done.
And that took 2.5 minutes.
All right, Anthony, how do you like our camping setup over here?
Love it. It's amazing.
Right?
Yeah.
Right?
And it
right?
Doesn't take that long to set up either.
No, it's like 2 minutes.
Yeah, 2.5 minutes and sturdy.
Yep.
Oh, the one thing I do have, I don't have one for my car.
You could. Go say hi to me. Hi to me, Dad.
Oh, goodbye.
Do? Kiko Hiro, you guys are Hiro, isho?
Okay, so one of the things we brought today are these spears for spear fishing. So like here, and then when you let go, you go pew. We're gonna catch a fish.
Okay. Just going swimming brings a pole.
Feels great. It's a little bit cold, but
now that's what you need, Albo.
I guess you could.
Yeah, that's the thing. You could just sleep in the back.
Yeah.
Screams America, and I love it.
Sparkle teeth. Okay, that was cool. He's just showing off.
That was cool. Amazing.
He just came down just to do like a little loop, and he's like, like, screw you guys.
Probably the same thought we had. Just like, too many people.
Yeah, that was fun. You want to go jump the river?
Sure.
Guys, so there is a little jumping off spot over there that I'm really scared of. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it, but let's go over there. Let's try to gather up the bravery, and maybe we'll just send it. Yeah, it's a little bit sketchy. This guy comes to River Adventure with no flip-flops, no slippers, although you did bring hiking boots to your credit. We're just about there, where there's like a little jump off point. I honestly don't know if I can do it. It's fucking high.
Dude, this is awesome. I love it.
Yeah.
Oh, this is great.
Topping the flow of water at the bottom.
This is like what summer's all about, you know?
Yeah.
What's going through your mind, my friend?
To be perfectly honest, you know, it's not the height that scares me. It's just like the getting hurt when I fall. And especially because we don't know how deep it is and where it's okay to jump. Yeah, let's just send it. All right.
All right. Like that, she's got a golf win, right?
It's not deep. Look at how tall our man is.
Woo! Yeah, buddy.
Not good, but I made it.
Dude, summer memory?
Summer memory.
Summer memory.
Hell yeah. Three years on jet. First time doing this.
This is great. This is why I come to Japan, right?
Oh yeah.
This is why I come to Japan.
Coast is gonna do it.
Woo! Woo!
Nice.
Nice.
All the boys did it.
That was super satisfying.
It was.
Got our
and
jump.
Relaxing.
Big jump and our flip. Let's head back, get some food.
All right.
Indiana Albo.
Yep. It's a little rope here.
Open eyes all. Yeah, if you're really crazy, some people actually jump from up here. Actually, this is as high as my fiance would jump for diving.
No regrets, right?
No regrets. No regrets at all. Look at my hair.
Is there a lesson in this, Anthony, that we can give the people? I think sometimes it's just fear that's holding you back.
Fear and overthinking.
Yep. Those go hand in hand. The more you overthink, the more scared you get.
Yep.
So sometimes just listen to your inner voice. If it sounds like, yeah, I can do it, just go for it.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a goal. Excited.
Oh. Wow, look at
this.
Got the little fish.
One fish.
There's a little waterfall over there. Let's go check it out. Feels so good, right?
Feels so nice. Without you.
Yeah, on the sand. Oh, there's a bamboo forest over here. Oh, the water's getting colder up here. Oh, look how beautiful this is. Look at this. This guy has the toughest feet ever. Look at you just crushing these rocks. You're making pebbles. All right, we have finally made it to the legendary waterfall over there. Can you do it, dude?
I'll try. I'll definitely try.
All right. Maybe up here might be easier.
Yeah.
Here's our little waterfall. The water is super cold. All right. Now I'm gonna sit underneath this like a monk. That's the idea.
Boss.
Come on in! Nice!
So, Abo, you found a nice resting place here.
It's a good meditation spot.
Yeah.
Let me just wait for the water to come. Let me use my mental energy. This is actually really cold, but it feels so good. Oh my god, it feels
great.
Go for it.
That's what they swim with. Ah, swim. Oh, Ijan, Ijan.
Ah,
Ijan. Ine. Swim with
that. Shirts off for the boys.
Shirts off for the boys. Dude, it's like a spiritual experience. Just get under there.
Oh, that feels amazing.
Yeah, right? Little guy, and now he's gonna continue his little journey. riding a horse.
And we're back. Good adventure.
All right, so we're gonna try Yes Chuka over here.
Wow, looks fancy.
Yeah, looks pretty good.
So Hiyashi Chuka is like a cold noodle that you, cold noodle dish that you have during the summer. And it's basically ramen noodles with some broth. Now it's also some spicy mustard. And then you have like various toppings that you put on it. So in my opinion, 7-Eleven makes the best Hiyashi Chuka. It literally means cold Chinese noodle. So after this, we're gonna pack up, go for a drive up a little Toby up there, see if there's any more spots we can get a good view, and then we'll call it a day, head back. All right, so we're gonna pack up the roof tent, and it's gonna take a couple minutes to actually add these to the timing.
All right, so now you can actually see, oh, hello, I'm there. 3, 2, 1. So it doesn't fly away.
Yep. What are we at? Minute 40?
Minute 50. Anyways, uncut 2.5 minutes. Faster to put it away than it was to take out.
Really?
Yeah.
Easy.
Yeah. Easy, easy.
Oh, you should set up camp wherever.
Yeah.
I love this thing.
How do you feel?
Yeah, it was great. I thought I was a bit sketchy there for a second with some of the bumps, but cleared it.
You were one wheel off.
Yeah, so, nope.
So he bought ice cream at the conveni. It's like 5 hours later.
They're
and
like little balls of ice cream. It's all melted, so now it's just gonna be this nice.
Show us the inside. Oh, that smells amazing.
It smells good. It's basically just grape juice. Unicorn spec. My unicorn down here.
Oh yeah, your unicorn down here?
Yep, yep. Bruno the unicorn.
Bruno, you named him.
Uh-huh. Well, he came with a name.
Oh, cool.
So this car's name's Bruno too.
Got your nice little torque set up here too.
Yep. Hopefully this doesn't fall over.
I'm yeah.
Right now. All right, so we just came out of here, just to get a picture here.
just really see the beauty of Japan here in the countryside. Traditional fishermen down there. Cool. Alright guys, so it's super fun. We're gonna end the video here because we're gonna head back. But in the next video, which is gonna be a continuation of this one, me and Anthony are actually gonna go for a drive up and down Haruna, and let's see if we can get into some drift hunter style adventures just like back in the day. So let's head over and let's have a good time.